So today I want to talk about smartphone addictions in teens and children. Okay, it's a big problem. There was a study done in 2016 involving 1,240 parents, and they found that 50% of teens felt addicted. No surprise there. 59% of parents believed that their kids were addicted. Okay, 77% of parents feel that their kids get distracted and lose attention. That's no surprise. Of course, you're going to be distracted. And 72% of teens felt that they needed to respond to text and social media immediately when they get this like text message, because texting, you get like a 95% open rate. So you have people that are just all day long, just responding. It's training you to respond versus email, which is, I think it's only like 15 or 20%. So it's definitely a problem because you're glued to this phone and you're literally addicted. I only check text messages maybe twice a day. Same thing with the email, because I found that I wasn't getting anything done at all because I'm constantly distracted. And when you think about multitasking, you think you're getting more stuff done. You're not. Your power is in your attention. So you really want to do what you're doing when you're doing it and not doing something else by doing this thing over here. 78% of teens check their devices at least hourly. I think it's a lot more frequent than that. Smartphone addictions are similar to drug addictions in that they do influence the size and shape of certain parts of the brain, specifically in the gray matter, the insula, and the temporal cortex, which is involved with emotion, speech, hearing, sight, memory, and self-control. They also found that there's more anxiety without your phone. And I think a lot of people, if they lose their phone or they forget their phone, they freak out because it's their lifeline. We depend on that phone. The problem is just the obsessive use of this phone and what it can do to your body, which we're going to cover in a minute. There's less social interaction with people in front of you because we're communicating through the phone. And a lot of people have insomnia and fatigue because of this cell phone. And so what is the real damage with our cell phones? It's the EMF, electromagnetic fields. There's two fields. One is the electric fields, which is different than the magnetic fields. I'm not going to get into the difference because I created a video on that, which I'll put a link down below. But I found when I measured my house with an EMF meter by my bed, there was a massive magnetic field because of the wiring in the back of the wall, which I had to hire an electrician to redo because I was literally being bathed in a sea of magnetic fields. And it was massively affecting my sleep cycle. So I fixed that, bam, sleep like a baby now. All right, so EMF affects the brain and it affects the heart mainly, but it affects other parts as well. It can even affect fertility. So if you put your cell phone in your pocket next to the gonads, you're literally sending microwaves into that area. Also, the blue light from the devices, not just your cell phone, but other devices, affects melatonin. So that's going to affect your sleep. So the main thing is damage control. How can we reduce the effect of EMFs on our body? Number one, avoid contact with your brain. Do not hold your cell phone up to your head. Also, if you have those earbuds or you have some type of earphones that go right into your brain, there's a very specific type you need to get. I think it's called earbuds or something, where there's a space between your brain and the wire. So you're not driving this current or these fields right into your brain, which is not good. Use a speaker on your phone, but keep it away from your head. Very important. And really interesting, when I was in practice, I did a series of talks to the Natural Science Institute. That's when I first got introduced to EMF, because there was a research scientist that came up to me and said, did you hear about some of the studies that they were doing on children developing brain tumors from exposure to EMF? And I'm like, really? What? So they were already involved in the research, and that increased my awareness on that connection. Number two, if you have a sleeping problem, you don't want to use the cell phone 2 to 3 hours before bed, because the blue light is going to interfere with your ability to sleep, the circadian rhythm, because it's going to affect melatonin. And the next thing is that get an EMF protection case, especially if you're carrying in your pocket. you want to limit the amount of exposure that you have the EMF by having this this case that can help at least reduce the exposure. All right, there you have it. But check out the videos I have down below.
Hey, before you go real quick, I have a course entitled How to Bulletproof Your Immune System. It's a free course. I want you to take it. And here's why. Here's you. Here is your environment. Everyone is focused on this over here, avoiding your environment. But what about here? What about strengthening your immune system? That's what's missing. This course will show you how to bulletproof yourself. And so you can tolerate and resist your environment much better by strengthening your own immune system. I put a link down in the description right down below. Check it out and get signed up today.